Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh channel. In this tutorial, we are going to check the details of connection using React Native NetInfo. We will see the type of the connection with instant change, and we will check the Wi-Fi and mobile data connection in details. Well, first we install the React Native NetInfo module from here. Go to the Android folder and run the gradle clean command to sync the gradle with the project. Now run the app. This is how we import NetInfo in the project. We use this event listener to follow the status of the net instantly. And for unsubscribe, we call its value again. Define the subscription value at the beginning of component construction equal to null. And in the component did mount, we set it equal to the event listener of NetInfo. We define a new function to change the state of the net. And in that state, we set the connection status. IsConnected is a Boolean value in the NetInfo that indicates whether a connection is established or not. We set the initial value of the connection status to false and put the function we defined inside the event listener of NetInfo. Now we will check the value of NetInfo subscription in the component we'll unmount. And if there is no null, we call it to stop the listener. Here we examine the value of the connection status and display the corresponding text. Refresh the app. The text is displayed correctly. Now we turn off Wi-Fi. And of course, we have to turn off mobile data to disconnect our connection. And as you can see, listener correctly detected that the connection is lost. Well, now we turn on Wi-Fi again to establish a connection. Well, now let's look at other properties. Type property specifies the type of current connection, which can have the value of none, unknown, cellular, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, Ethernet, WiMAX, VPN, and other. Here we set the type of connection state. And we set the initial value to null. Now we create another text to show us the type. By changing the network connection, we see its type. We use the isConnected property to determine if it was connected or not. But the value of this property does not indicate the internet connection. To find out if there is an internet connection or not, we use the isInternetReachable property. Save its value in the state. And set its value to false by default. Here we create a new text and display the availability of the internet in it. Well, as you can see, there is internet access right now. I disconnect the internet, but connect the Wi-Fi connection to see the result. As you can see, there is a connection, but the internet is not available. The same is true for cellular connection. Well, we will re-establish the internet. We use the isWiFi enable property to detect whether Wi-Fi is on or off. Of course, this property only works on Android. Well, set the value. And display it in the text. Change the connection, and you see the result. Now let's look at the details property. The value of this property varies depending on the type. If the type is none or unknown, the value of details is null. If type is Wi-Fi, the details are included in the values we are checking. We set the details state. In a new text, we show the details. Here we look at the two types of Wi-Fi and cellular details. Well, first we check the Wi-Fi type. The first property is connection expensive, which indicates whether the connection costs the user or not. In this case, as you can see, the connection is free. The next properties are SSID and VSSID, which requires confirmation of access file location permission in Android. Here, because permission is not given to the app, the SSID will be undefined. The next property is the strength, which indicates the strength of the network connection signal with a number between 0 and 100. Here, our connection signal strength is 99. The next property is the IP address, which shows the external IP address and can be version 4 or 6. This property shows the network subnet in version 4. And finally, frequency shows the network frequency only in Android. This number means the same as 2.4 GHz. Well, now let's look at cellular type. Change the connection to mobile data. The first property is connection expensive, which usually always costs money. The next property is cellular generation, which shows the generation of the SIM card network. This value can be null, 2G, 3G, or 4G. Here, our value is 4G. The next property is the carrier, which shows the name of the network provider. Because our device is an emulator, the provider name shows Android. If the type is Bluetooth, Ethernet, WiMAX, or other, details only shows the value of is connection expensive. On platforms that do not support locally displaying internet availability, we use these settings to customize the existence of the internet. We can also use fetch for direct use of NetInfo and without listener. It actually gives us the same outputs we received, and we can even limit it based on type. Well, let's review the connections once. Wi-Fi connection, with these details. Mobile data or cellular connection, with these details. And this in case of disconnection. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, please ask me in the comment section. I will be happy to help you. Don't forget to subscribe. I will see you in the next video.